Inshallah, we're going to start. Alhamdulillah, Shaitan Rajim, Bismillah, Rahman Rahim. So, we will do, inshallah, two ayats of Surah Al Baqarah today. Ayat number 14 and 15. The topic in both of these ayats are still about the munafiqeen, the hypocrites of Al Medina. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning few things about the munafiqeen, about the hypocrites in these ayats. So we'll do first a simple translation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayat number 14, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَإِذَا لَقُوا And when they meet, the munafiqeen or the hypocrite meet, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا To those people who have believed. So the believers are there and munafiqeen are meeting with them. Okay. So when they meet to them, قَالُوا They say, the munafiqeen say, the hypocrites say, آمَنَّا Just one word here is, آمَنَّا means we have believed. They say we have believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Quran. Then Allah says, وَإِذَا خَلَوْا And when they are alone, إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ With their other friends or other people who are evil people, evil, bad people, قَالُوا They say, the munafiqeen say to those people, إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ Indeed we are with you. We are actually with you. Innama nahnu mustahzi'un In fact, we were just joking with the believers. We were just making fun. We were just laughing. We were doing mockery with them. We are actually with you. So when they meet with the believers, they say we have believed. But when they go back to their own people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling them shayateen, which is the evil people, evil friends. Then munafiqeen tell them, we are actually with you. We were just joking with the other peoples, we were making fun of them by saying that we believed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is responding to this statement by saying in the next ayat, Allahu yastahziyo. Actually Allah is doing this mockery with them, which means What Allah is doing mockery means Allah has left them in their state, in their condition, and they will not be guided. That's what the meaning is. Why Allahu yastahziu bihim? Allah is the one who is actually he left them in their state of mockery. Wa yamudduhum and he prolongs, he stretches fi tughyanihim in their rebelling, in their transgression, in their going beyond the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the last word is Ya'mahoon. Ya'mahoon means someone who wanders blindly. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling munafiqeen that they are wandering blindly and Allah has left them in their state of misguidance. So this is brief translation. So let's look at these ayats from the beginning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا لَقُوا Okay. So the word starts with wa and the next word is إِذَا إِذَا means when. Okay. Now there are two words in the Quran which come very often. Idh and Iza, both of these words mean when. But when you see the word Idh without this extra alif there, Idh means something that is being talked about the past, when something happened in the past. But when Iza is used, something which is happening now or in the future. Both mean, the meaning of both these words is when. But one is used when you talk about the past, the other is used when you're talking about the future present. So here in this case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran is being revealed, everything is present, munafiqeen are there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa ida and when. Okay? Next word here, it starts with these letters, lam, qaf, and ya. The meaning of these is to meet. Lam, qaf, and ya means to meet. Two people meet to each other or more than two. Okay? The word from here is laqu. Laqu means they met. This is the past tense of third person plural. They met. And that's the word in the Quran. And when they met. They met. And they here is the munafiqeen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the munafiqeen, the hypocrite, that when they met. Okay? Also, you can translate this as, because it's a present, Iza is making the whole statement present, you can translate that when they meet. Okay? Both are correct. Because of the Iza. Iza brings the present situation. So you can say when they meet. When the munafiqeen meet, the hypocrite meets the believers. Okay? So when they meet or when they met, and when they meet. وَإِذَا لَقُوا when and when they meet or they met, but they here is the munafiqeen. Okay? So what happens when they meet? And who do they meet? Then the next two words are لَذِي is the starting word. لَذِي means he. Its plural is ladina. Ladina means those. Ladina means those. Okay? And if you put al before that, it is al ladina, and that means the, means some special people. Okay? Allazina means those. Okay? Allazina. Then the next word starts with these. We have seen that many times and it will come again. Alif, Hamza, Alif, Meem, and Noon. Amana. Amana means to believe. Okay? To believe. And if I put a vowel at the end, it becomes Amanu. Amanu means they believed. Amana is one person believed. Amanu, many, many people believed. So the word now is Alladhina Amanu. These two words have to go together. Alladhina Amanu. So these two words from here up to here have to go together. Alladhina Amanu. Those who believed. Okay, so this we have to translate these two words together. Those who believed. Or you can translate that as believers. those or those people who believed are the believers. Okay, so we can translate that as believers. Alladina amanu, those who believed, or those are the ones who are believers. So now we have two groups here. First group is Ba'idha Laku, and these are Munafiqeen. And these Munafiqeen are meeting with the believers. So now Munafiqeen and believing people are meeting to each other. Okay? So that's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reporting that story or the incident that some Munafiqeen went and met those people who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is Allazina amanu and Waiza laku. So what happened after that? Qalu. The next word is Qalu. Okay? And again, this word starts with these three letters, Qaf, Waw and Lam, which means to say, and if I put three fathas and waw changes into alif, qala, he said, and its plural is qalu, they said. So the word Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using, Qalu, they said. Now who are they here? Munafiqeen. So when those two parties met to each other, Munafiqeen said something. Hypocrites something, said something. So they said. They said. Munafiqeen said something. What did they say? One word only. Amanna. Okay. So let's look at the word here. So we just saw this word. Amana. This means to believe. Now from the rules that we have seen, if we have these three letters, Fa and Lam, which means to do, and if I put an Na at the end, like this thing, Fa'alna, by adding Fa at the end, the meaning becomes we did. So when you have the three letters and you put na at the end, the meaning becomes we, first person, plural, and the past tense. So fa'alna, we did. So if I put na at the end of this word here, this will become we believed. Okay? And these, there are two noons together, so this will be written as A Manna with a Shadda here. A Manna. This is Aman and this is Na. Amanna. Amanna means we believed. So Munafiqeen or hypocrite are saying to the believers, we believed. Just one word. And we believe means we believe in Allah, we believe in the Quran, we believe in the Prophet. We are believing. But they are lying actually. They are not speaking the truth, but they are lying. They are just saying to them, we believed. Now what happens? After saying that, these munafiqeen and hypocrites went back to their people. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying next. Wa'idha, which is the same word as there, and when. Okay. And when now the next word ha, lam and waw are the root word letters, and this means to be alone. To be alone. Halau means to be alone. Or to be free. Okay. For example, there's a word in Farsi, khalwat. Lone, to be alone. Khalau means to be alone. Okay. So this word is khalau, means when they are alone. When they are alone. Okay. Khalau. Halau means they are alone. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that, and these people, munafiqeen, when they are alone,